That was one aspect about it. The other thing is, which is one of the interesting things about illustration and why it's interesting going from one author to another and one book to another, is that is the sort of tuning in on what this is like. And I mean, the crocodile is a kind of embodiment of evil energy, as it were. It's like Richard III or someone like that. You know, kind of thing. I mean, you it's terrible, but you like to watch it. And it seemed to me that it was because it was there were frightening things in it. It wanted to be, in a sense, artificial or heraldic. So that, and he describes how he's, you know, he's got hundreds of teeth which rattle together and so on and so on. And it seemed to me it was like the crocodile in Punch and Judy in a way, you know, that had, you know, comes out and goes like this sort of thing. And so it is actually a sort of caricature of a crocodile. And crocodiles actually, I mean, I know that crocodiles don't actually look like that, but so it's got teeth. Which are sort of like a saw kind of set of teeth, which are, they're really for catching children, and they're a trap, as it were. You know, as I drew it, the crocodile sort of developed into what it is, and also the children are real, but it's a kind of artificial pantomime situation, or rather frightening kind. Well, I mean, pantomime can be a frightening kind. And so they tend to be slightly strong heraldic colours, as it were, very green, or, you know, some bright flowers and so on, which gives the kind of mood of the book. And to do that, you've got to design the whole book before you start to do it. You've got to do the rough drawings of the whole book so that you know how the text fits in. And then it's done with a pen and ink. And that pen is a rather harder pen than one that I might use, say, for doing those Michael Rosen books or another book by Dahl, perhaps, you know. So it's quite a sort of hard movement in it, you know. It relates to all those teeth as you draw them. And they're quite bright, flat colours in places. And as I say, you have to draw the whole thing so you can fit the text in. And that, again, is a nice thing about a picture book, is that you, and nice for me, is that you... you arrange where you, in a sense, design it, because you arrange where everything goes in the book, and you tell the story in that sequence. And in fact, there was a thing that I was doing wrong at the beginning, which is absolutely basic, which Tom Masher was able to point out, because he's very good at looking at books and seeing what works. Is that I was getting you've got to get the suspense on one opening, and the resolution when you turn the page, so that you reach a point at which what is going to happen. Whereas I was sort of giving the problem on the left-hand page and the answer on the right. And you mustn't do that. You've got to have the problem on the left-hand page, so you turn the page, which is what keeps you turning the pages, because you want to see. And that goes through all picture books, or nearly all picture books, not quite all, but it's a sort of fundamental thing. So that was that. I was a bit frightened of it to begin with, but there's rather a lot of biting people went into it. But I think I sort of tuned into it, and then that was it as far as I knew.